Welcome to the Ether. Today is Friday, November 18th, 2022. Today on the Ether, part one of the two-part Rack FM Cosmos Spaces official launch party of the Honorary Council of Racks. Let's fucking take a listen.
James, quickly, before anybody comes in, what's happening? I've just put the computers on and Nixon's track. Mate, I can't grab it. I guess just taking the piss. Hurry up before the room gets too big. Gaines, can you play that track? The mastered WAV, yeah? Or not? Quickly. I'm getting... This site can't be reached. I don't know what's wrong.
I got you. Yeah, give me a second.
Did you download it? It wouldn't download for me. It wouldn't download. I'll go and get your man Joe and Barnes up the speakers. Dude, find the track, the mastered one, while at the small room. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, working on it right now. Yes, sir. Did you make a tweet yet, Robo?
Not yet. There's time gains for that, because, yeah.
Yeah.
And you know something? The rogue, like... We'll semi-rogue tonight, because I think we're all on the back end of all the rogues. So we'll have a slow one with Finn. I've got a plan. I'm going to drop the three blind racks. See how they run. See how they play. They all ran after the plebs' wife who got on her knees and prayed for life. Did you ever see such a sight in your life as three blind racks? Hello, Joe. Joe, we got Joe. Hey, Joe's loving this shit. He's like, racks get shit done. Hello, Joe. Tonight's history, dude.
Hey, morning, man. How's everything going?
Well, Joe, we're all the better for seeing you, and we're going to make history. And it's after we've done something to help the community, like selfless members like yourself. I just think it's fantastic. I think. Considering we're at like the bottom of the borough market, and a lot of like the new tech, or you know, when you look at like Stargaze and blah blah blah, and all the stuff Liquid Staking, Mesh Security, you know, we're in the infancy, and we're at the bottom, and we're having fun, and I mean that must count for like something, like Joe, it's got to be like if you can have a party at the bottom. Imagine what we're going to do when we get to the top, Joe. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, that's a good way to look at it. I think if Timmy's serious and there's going to be NFTs of my face, I'm calling the bottom right here. And you know what? The market top was when I started my Twitter and my YouTube. That was the top, and this is the bottom.
Started from the bottom, now we're here.
Started, you know what's funny? One of my friends who's been in crypto since like 2012, he was messaging me. He's like, oh yeah, you could always tell when the market top is because a bunch of goons are on YouTube talking about crypto. And that was like the day after I started my YouTube channel and didn't tell him.
Started.
Daddy on the chain.
Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team fucking here. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here. Nigga, started from the bottom, now we here.
It's a little bit of motivation for Mr. Joe over there.
Wait. No. I'm texting. Right, Gaines, I've said just there, I've just tweeted. I'm like, you got 5 minutes. So I know, I mean, it's early for bands, very early. And she was up extremely like late last night. I know Joe isn't ready for this. Al can't speak. However, I said to everybody, guys, 5 minutes. And your man Gaines is going to drop an exclusive, like well ahead of time. I mean, it's recorded, but we can easily get like Finn to like delete this, like no problem. Like the minute he's got the recording, we can just delete this shit straight away in a few minutes. Because I don't know why I can't get this. Gaines, that files.fm.
I'm ready to go.
I bet you are. But I've called people, called them up. We'll give them some time. Yeah. However, I need to get some tweets ready now. I need to get some tweets ready, I think, like, and the slow rogue. Gaines, are you exhausted? I think we need like a 2 week break, like the hardcore racks. We need like a 2 week holiday, and like we need to like pass the banner on to others. Like we need to pass the torch on to like the younger generation to take over. You know what I mean?
No. Yeah, I know what you mean. I know what you mean there, Mr. Robo. But I don't think we're gonna call this quits, right? I think it's just a well deserved vacation. You know what I'm saying?
What's the title? Does that say Rock FM X Cosmos Spaces official launch party? My God, what's this? The Honorary Council. Because guys, what you're going to find out very soon is that I had to work very hard to get my honorary. And then when I became the first person to like get in there and claim the honorary through hard work, yeah, what happened next? I wasn't happy. Why wasn't I happy? Because there were people missing. Who was missing at the time? Rama and McKenna, or Rakenna as we call them now. Now listen, guys, there's only seven of you in the room. Good evening, Seffi, and it's good morning your time. Yeah, it's very early for Seffi. Early in the morning, he's on his way home, probably. I hope so. Guys, listen, about these honoraries. When I got mine, I wasn't comfortable because it wasn't just me. And I'm going to put this in the nest in a minute. At this time, for me to bring out receipts, right? I was like, guys, you know something? A couple of days after, I was like, this is uncomfortable. Rama was there sniping the contracts. McKenna was the, you know, McKenna and Inc. were the first one, like 1%. And then they bought a lot more, trust me. Even though he's been very, very quiet. And this is something that will come up in if Rain Man comes tonight, Rakenna will come up in conversation. Because he's an OG of OGs, but he's been like a silent partner, right? And I care about the people who are working, striving towards what we're trying to achieve, right? With Raccoon, which is like the ultimate, like decentralization, pure like community owned, where we pay clever people to do clever work, and we all like come together as a hive mind and take care of the other shit, while our cool guys take care of the coding, right? There's been so much shit, right? These honoraries, I was never comfortable being the only one. Since we got Rama in, he was already, guys, an honorary, wait, and then we had the big rogue, where we all rogued Rama live online. It's history, it's famous, blah, blah, blah. But then I rogued everyone with the Matrix, PFP for Rama, the one-on-one. I mean, you can't get these, guys. You cannot get these raccoons. I mean, if you do get one, like, you're blessed, man, right? And I was like to Mol, look, Mol, the guys are going to do this. Like, this is proper hardcore, what we're about to do to Rama. Like, he's not a silent partner, right? McKenna is a silent partner right now. When he chooses not to be, then I'm going to go down the route of like, right, okay, McKenna, we're going to sort you out, right? But the title of this space is the Honorary Council. That's what's coming tonight. Up to now, there are essentially two members, myself and Rama, but he doesn't know. There are a couple of other members who I've spoken to, and these members are the most productive members in the community. And if you look at my bio, you know, the raccoon Sherpa, I'm trying to carry the lot on my back, whether that be devs, whether that be the fucking socials, whatever's going on, right? There's been this thing where, guys, listen, in Raccoon, there are OGs, right? But they're taking a back seat. Then there are people who are putting hours into the organization. And the OGs will understand when I say it, and I said this weeks ago, the people who are putting in the daily graft now at the bottom of the barrel, when it's really important, yeah, they're the people who need rewarding. At Gaines, we have a very small room. We have 9 people. I think this is enough. It is recorded. Gaines, would you like to play a song for everybody listening? Yeah, I'll go quiet, dude. Just play this song for us, yeah? No one's heard this. This is Gaines, this is like a world exclusive, right, dude? Yeah?
World exclusive, never before heard. You guys ready?
Make sure you guys are in
a quiet place to listen to this, all right? And if it's a good, if the audio's good, throw me a thumbs up, okay? If not, I'll get the phone a little bit closer to the speaker. No, no, no.
Thumbs up, dude. No worries. No worries. Go.
3, 2, 1.
This is the new Raccoon, kicking your ass with fresh bars. With fists on the full moon, when we fly high to the stars. Cold spaceship, the raccoons, thousand eyes in the dark. Trash pandas are nice, but we're kicking it hard. Kicking it like robot toes, taking the track logo, yo. Spit on all, no low blows, me and Sin hit all your hoes. Making chills like kings, bring new deals for the win. Ching, ching for the bling, wreck will big, pin, pin. Wreck will never sleep, sit party hardy. Vodka, gin, beer, Henny and some Bacardi. 100% in, nothing partly. Fun never ends here, just daily starting. No wait for the fat check, when you place on the best bet. Just collect with the best pack, with the Mac in the background. Lay effects on the racks track, to prep you for the best, yeah. So connect with the best track, to show respect for the rack dad. Rack got your back, rack, rack got your back. As one with a pack, all hands on the deck. Rack with a tap, rack, rack with a tap, tap, tap. On the stash, rack, racks for the best. Rack got your back, rack, rack got your back. As one with a pack, all hands on the deck. Keeper respect from my chest, trash panda biker gang for the rack, black belt. 110 NFTs checked in my rack backpack. Blaze in your place with haze and some pace. Blaze in the cake, just staking and wave. We coming hard in the club, wrecks not fake. Shooting dice with the great, straight in your face. All my friends furry, eyes blurry, always in a hurry. Staring up the birdie, plebs hurting, angry bots lurking. Effortless looking, but wrecks always working. Put my bed on the desk, on a rack with a hat, black vest, with a pack and a Mac in the back, rap. Rap with laser beams, starting war with memes again. Big win from my lit rack team. Rack at your back, rack, rack at your back. As one with a pack, all hands on the deck. Rack with a tat, rack with a tat, tap, tap on the stash, rack, racks for the best. Rack at your back, rack, rack at your back. As one with a pack, all hands on the deck. Rack with a tat, rack with a tat. Shit, cause I'm down winning that shit. Fresh Panda Biker Gang up in this bitch. Shiloh selling out, phony racks are digging deep. I'm a trash panda motherfucker and my brothers keep up. NFTs on my plate are too sick to debate. RIC with the K, put enjoy on my face. Easy stat with my name, Hall of Fame to be safe. Playing games, placing bets, taking coins on my craze. Saying grace with a gang, sharing space with my fam. Going in with a bang, do the song, just a slam in the group chat with the champs of the rap fam. In the back, on the black of the back lab. Lay back on my ass, have a laugh on the space. Few girls and my gents always ready for a blast. Nothing less than the max, only best for my racks. Still chill and relax, lay bets on my racks. Rack at your back, rack at your back ass.
Hey, games killer, with games killer. Wow. Wait a minute, games I mean, for me personally, I don't know about anyone else, but that sounded like shit. But it always does with spaces and earbuds or whatever. Wait. But guys, when you listen to this track properly, right, which you will do soon, it's banging. I mean, your man's a little bit like insecure about like dropping it. But Gaines, I think the rawness, and especially like considering like English is not his first language, the rawness of like that track, it should be dropped the way it is. Like people were talking about auto-tune, I'm the singing and blah, blah, blah. Dude, he should drop that the way it is. We're going to put a video together now.
I don't know.
What do you think,
Gaines? Let me get some feedback from Joe, because he might not have a Motorola Razr speaker, you know. Joe, did you hear that? Did it sound good?
Yeah, it sounded pretty good. I'm on like a nice $5 set of earphones here, and it sounded fine.
It sounds way better with that file that you sent me, Robo. There's like tons of bass.
The WAV. In that file. Yeah. The mastered WAV one is fucking exceptional. Guys, if you're in this room, like you're privileged, like you're one of who were four people like in the world who's heard this. So if anyone hasn't heard Nixon's like original like rap, and this all goes back to the original raccoon giveaways, and how Nixon got my first ever, like I gave 6 raccoons away back in the day, like before raccoons were even a thing. I gave like 6 away for people making raps, people doing meme competitions. I mean, I love this community. And Gaines, man, we just fucking keep hitting levels. So, dude, Rock FM, Cosmos Spaces, official launch party. We're going to integrate all of the entire organization into Cosmos Spaces. So, Stinky in the brain, where projects are going to come on and get absolutely fucking scrutinized to death if they're there. We're going to do the Rock FM Monday to Thursday minimum. For the cultures are coming out during the day. Again, are we birthing a movement? I might be wrong. I think we're birthing a movement right now.
Absolutely. You're not talking shit. We are. And that's just the beginning. And that's only just one collaboration there, right? Iraq and Cosmos Spaces. That's just one. Imagine collaborating with other people.
How many subs is John now? You see us through that, man. We just absolutely adore. How good is this shit? Like, this is, yeah, it's unstoppable. I would love to hear like what Seffy thinks of the pure grassroots movement that we're determined to behold and be flag bearers of, because it's something to me that's the only thing that's going to break the status quo eventually. Is this like feeling that you have this sense of camaraderie with your fellow human being who will stand next to you and say like, yeah, I know the difference between right and wrong. That's right. That's wrong. I'm a bit of a black and white guy, like guys, in regards to like what's right and what's wrong. No, but I'm sure you'll agree. You know what I mean?
We know exactly what you mean, bro.
Dude, it was like Joe, though. Like Joe, right? Just speaking up about the Fifth Amendment the other week. And then he started getting a load of shit, right? And I'm like, fucking hell, man. Your man's like living in a place like it's one of the most like restrictive places in the entire country. And like you're giving him shit for like believing that he should be able to protect himself. in his house where essentially someone can come in armed and he can't fucking do anything. And he has to sit there like a playboy, like people like rob his house or do shit to his family. It's like, and people are like, nah. And I'm like, yeah, fucking shut up, man. Let your man speak. Let your man have his fucking opinion, man. He's probably saying to his kid anyway now. That was class. Oh, Bans is up. Hello, Bans, darling. Hey, good morning, Bans.
I saw it open, so I popped it in, but I'm trying to also make breakfast. What do you guys talk on and on about? And what is this? You guys are
doing my brother's keeper. Am I my brother's keeper? Nixon's dropping the rap. Bans, I'll tell you what. I'll hook you up in the DM. Can I drop you the track in a minute? Who's in here? I'm going to drop you the track for a laugh. Like, guys, he's so nervous about this, man. And there's so much, like, Gaines is a lot. I mean, even if it gets changed before it gets dropped on YouTube, how good is that rap? And this is what I said. The guys, there's a video of me saying, like, how good is that rap? I think Al, in this room, probably only Al remembers, like, that. I'm sure he does. Al gives a thumbs up. Nah, he's probably busy. There's a video, guys, a meme video of me on YouTube. And you'll hear me saying, how good is that rap? And this is Nixon's second rap. The first one, you can go and get it on their stash. Nixon's rap. The first one, Welcome to Rackville. It's an NFT on stash. You can go along it and go and download it. That one, though, is a classic. Gaines, how do we? We've only got like 9 people and there's a few people missing.
Yeah.
I know they're busy. How do we introduce the honorary council? How do we bring the honorary council into the conversation? I'm not too sure.
I think we should just hold off a little bit until we get some more people that are probably just barely waking up and getting the kids to school and stuff. No, just give them a few more minutes. But we can change topics until then. What do you think?
So what you're saying is 8 a.m. is the benchmark, isn't it? We've been Rack FM's been like an hour early tonight, yeah.
Yeah.
It has.
Exactly. I think right now.
Games?
Yeah.
What time did you guys end that space? A few hours ago.
About 2 hours ago, yeah. An hour and a half, 2 hours ago.
We're fucking.
Well, like I mean, there it is, guys. People are probably like sleeping. You guys have like 40 people, 50 people deep in there. And they're like, listen, we're greedy. We're raccoons, and we're gonna usurp your time.
Wait, Bans.
So you're gonna be back here in 2 years.
You were just asleep. You went to bed like a few hours ago. How are you awake right now?
No, I was already asleep. Listen, I had kids in the middle of the night. I have to go pee pee. I can't hold it all night long. Okay.
Oh.
So that was like my time to go to the bathroom, and you guys were on. So then.
After that woman,
hey,
Banshee, a woman, that city woman, she's a fucking screamer. She's an absolute fucking gas rocket. I was pissing myself listening to your woman. She's just like she's ranting rich. On like she's, she, I bet she's gone from a normal voice to like Siri. And then she's, yeah, mama, Italian. And your man pissed himself. Didn't he? Did he fuck off Gaines when he pissed himself or not? JPEG. What's his name? No. JPEG 3 or something. What's his name? Who's that pleb?
The MP3 guy? Wasn't that crazy though? Like,
so how many subs does Cosmo Joe have, guys? Did he get like, wait, did he get over 1,000 or did he get 1,000?
I'll not sleep until he gets over fucking Don Plebtonium. The minute Joe Cosmos Joe beats Don Plebtonium, I'll give up. I'll retire. Okay.
I need, if I overtake him, there'll be a big party.
Joe, I never asked you, how do you feel about all this? Like people putting their, you know, they also have like a freaking, they have a, an NFT coming out on Stargaze.
Yeah, I think this is the market bottom. I told him this is the bottom right here. I'm gonna unload all my stable coins into whatever and just ride it up. I said today is the day that this is the bottom. This is the bottom.
Yeah, you know that's funny. Oh, I'm actually divesting, just making sure I have enough dry powder for when things go lower and lower. So I really think it's
well, wait. If you were Sunny right now and you weren't very happy with Timmy, you'd absolutely fucking crucify him, right, wouldn't you?
You know, Timmy's the last person I thought would get involved with this, so this is definitely the bottom.
Oh, he's left himself wide open. He has. Where's the money going? Charity. Every penny must go to charity.
So listen, how does he have this NFT? Like, if everyone buys it, is this NFT just going to him since he's the creator of the NFT? Or what is the point? Like, what is he going to do with the NFT?
Who's going to do what with the NFT?
Joe's NFT. I'm going to get one just to have one and keep it.
I saw the tweet. And apparently he's running it like a lottery. Whoever, I didn't know you guys were going to make all different ones. I thought you can just have like one NFT and pass it around. But he's got like a set of 16 and it says, whoever gets all 16 first wins all of the mint proceeds.
There's different NFTs, so they're not all going to look the same, but the ones that he's talking about, yes, there's only a limited amount, but if you collect all those, then you get to collect all the mint funds, and then the royalties, 10% go to Spark IBC. Not sure what he's planning to do with the royalties, like, and how Spark IBC will use them up in the end, but maybe you could propose an idea, because he's got that, you know, that campaign. The Spark campaign. But are you minting or not? And I think, Joe, the best idea for you right now, as your advisor, right? I'm your advisor now. I think the best for you would be to do a live stream on YouTube going over NFT projects on Stargaze. And then out of nowhere, just, you know, yours pops up and you're like, oh, wow, what's this? Oh, hey, look, it's me. And then let me show you how to mint an NFT.
Mint me.
You gotta do it, bro, for the culture.
I'm still due to have Timmy on my channel do a YouTube video about Spark. And I just don't know how I don't understand how the NFT collection fits into Timmy's mission. Whatever he could do with it, good for him.
Joe, you could sue him right now. You know, you could probably, if because America, you sue each other to fucking death, don't you? Even the Thais, like, when you speak, like, you see the Thais, like, oh, what do you think about Americans? And like, oh, just sue each other like the lawyers, like, that's all it is. They do. It's no shit as well, man, guys. That's a true story. Joe, you could sue the motherfucker right now. Tender Joe, no? Trademark, no? Trademark?
Why would I'm not going to sue him. I'm going to sue Stargaze. Stargaze has the money.
Damn, son.
Dude, you're acting like Donna right now. Chill.
Don't you know I learned this in like 11th grade, the deeper pocket theory. You always sue who has the most money, whether they're wrong or not.
You know what? I'll change my PFP, Joe.
I would gladly take. I need like a 20-second clip of that track to use as my intro, and then I think that'll be. I'll drop.
Rack from the stash rack man from the distant. Yeah, you heard that, man. Wait a minute, Kane. There's some people joining. Can we put it on again? We've got Joe Man. What the fuck is this? We've got Joe Mama FTX. We've got Joe Man. All the Joes are coming in the room. We've got Mia, Ed, Joe. We've got, again, going to have to play the song again now.
Let me know when. The song.
Dude, my sound must be shit, but I hope it's okay for everybody else. Go on, knock it out again. Guys, are you ready? There's like 16 in the room. Let's listen. Will you hear Robbo's? Robbo's name dropped.
Give me one.
Take it away again.
Yeah. You got to give me a second because I might have to restart it.
Dude, when you have the speech on our home pleb, here after he talked to like Seppi and Bruce last night, his audition. Let's get him up, but he hasn't heard it yet either. Home pleb hasn't heard yet. Home pleb.
Are you rewinding the cassette?
it's fucking yes, because it was. It's that song Snap.
This fucking pleb sends it to me on Twitter. I mean, I don't know why he sends it to me.
I've got the power. That's what the band is on about now. I've got the power.
Was that?
I want that for my intro music. That's what I want.
Joe, was the audio okay though? Or should I make it a little bit louder when you heard it?
I think it was good. I think it was good. It woke my kid up. I think it was good.
All right, here it goes.
It won't make it up.
You're welcome.
This is the new Electrum kicking your ass with fresh bars. With bits on the full moon, let me fly high to the stars. Whole spaceship with raccoons, thousand eyes in the dark. Trash pandas are nice, but we're kicking it hard. Kicking it like robot toes, sticking with track logo, yo. Spit on all, no low blows. Me and Sin hit all your hoes. Hiking chills like kings, bring new deals for the win. Ching ching for the bling, wreck will big pin pin. Wreck will never sleep, sit party hardy. Vodka, gin, beer, Henny and some Bacardi. 100% in, nothing partly. Fun never ends here, just daily starting. No wait for the fat check when you place on the best bet. Just collect with the best pack, with the Mac in the back. Rally effects on the rack track to prep you for the best yet. So connect with the best rack to show respect for the rack dad. Rack at your back, rack at your back. As one with a pack, all hands on the deck. Rack with a tad, rack with a tad. Tap on the stash, up racks for the best. Rack at your back, rack at your back. As one with a pack, all hands on the deck.
Rap with a tap. All hands on deck. Oh my god.
With the Rex, Rex, my brother's keeper, respect from my chest. Trash panda biker gang for the rack. Black belt, 110 FTs checked in my rack backpack. Blaze in your place with haze and some pace. Glaze in the cake, just staking and vape. We coming hard in the club. Rex, not fake. Shooting dice with the great. Straight in your face. All my friends furry. Eyes blurry. Always in a hurry. Staring up the birdie. Plebs hurting. Angry bots lurking. Effortless looking. But Rex always working. Put my bet on the desk. On a rack with a hat. Black vest. With a pack and a Mac in a back wrap. Rack with laser beams. Starting war with memes. Again, big win from my lit rack team. Rack at your back. Rack, rack at your back.
Plebs hurting. Is anybody else? Plebs hurting.
Spinning that shit, cause I'm down winning that shit. Trash panda biker gang, up in this bitch. Shiller selling out, phony racks are digging deep. I'm a trash panda motherfucker, I'm my brother's keeper. NFTs on my plate, are too sick to debate. RIC with the K, putting joy on my face. Easy stat with my name, Hall of Fame to be safe. Playing games, placing bets, taking coins on my craze. Saying grace with a gang, sharing space with my fam. Going in with a bang, do the song, just a slam. In the group chat, with the champs of the rack fam. In the back on the black of the back lab. Lay back on my ass, have a laugh on the space. Few girls and my gents always ready for a blast. Nothing less than the max, only best for my racks. Still chill and relax, lay bets on my racks. Rack at your back, rack, rack at your back. As one with a pack, all hands on the deck. Rack with a tad, jack, rack with a tad. Tap, tap on the stash, up racks for the best. Rack at your back, rack, rack at your back.
Wow. Fucking hell, wow, wow, wow. Rap, architect, my god. Hey, Gaines, serious conversation. Gaines, serious conversation. Why, after fucking 3 months, has your man Seffy not got a rap tat? Like, I fucking lie awake at night thinking, what's going on? Is he going to just fucking rug the entire thing, like, or something? Why is your man, Steffi? What's going on? Why is your man, Steffi, not out of rack?
Here's one thing.
Can you imagine if he saw?
You said this is a serious conversation, right? Here's the thing. I will not be doing any fucking rack tats. Any fucking rack tats for people that will not put them on their PFP and leave them there. All right. If you want to rack that, you ask for one. I'll make one. It takes me time, but if you do get it, I expect to see it on your PFP. At least
you want me to change mine. I'll change my PFP now.
I'm not finished. Sorry. I'm back.
Dude, I'm scared. I wasn't done,
but if you upload it to the honorary collection on Stash App and you do your traits and all that, cool. I won't give you shit for not displaying it as a PFP. But from time to time, I would love to see people display them as their PFP when they come into these kind of spaces, right? Or those special occasions when we host a space for Mole and the team. But I've done already a few rag tats for people, and they don't use them as their PFP. So it's like a complete waste of time. And they're not even putting them on the honorary collection on Stash App. Are you there? Fucking Robo. Did I rug you, dude?
I am. But I think that's very powerful. And I think that carries weight. That, you know, I mean, I know my PFP, like, blah, blah, blah. I'm carrying that culture, like, icon, trying to, blah, blah, blah. But he's actually, what he's saying is, like, incredibly correct. If you have got a rack and you have had a tatted, it should be on the Hall of Fame, right? And it should be front and center when you join. Because it's no joke that, like, we're raccoons, like, all of us, like, to some degree, whatever. But, like, you know, out of respect, though, like, it's quite easy. Tank did it there. Tanks just doxed himself. Like, you know, moving forward, right? But, like, last night, he still, like, changed the PFP to Joe for the culture, yeah? So, like, when you do join these spaces, like, out of respect, like, wait a minute, what's Gaines? Have you changed your PFP or something? What's he done? His skin's changing or not? Fucker, I'm getting rugged here myself, probably. He's talking about PFP changes. Wait a minute. Oh, no. Oh, he's got the jaw. All right. Okay. He's got the jaw one. Gaines, have you just changed that again?
No.
Is that a different background or something?
No, I didn't change it.
Is that the raccoon dot bet background?
Yeah.
Hey, you've got a point, though, dude. You've got a point. He's got a point, though, hasn't he? Like, if you're going to come to rack spaces, right? If you own a rack, yeah, get it up, be proud of it, it's a badge of honor, come in, have some crack. You've all been listening. I can't believe Gaines, they've got a world exclusive, haven't they? Where's your man Ram at? Where's Shoebox? I invited Shoebox ages ago, man. It's nearly midnight this time. He must be out on the sauce, Ram, and that Rama's got to be out on the sauce, or he's really tired. Like,
yeah, he's been really busy with work, dude. Been a very, very busy guy. But wasn't he cracking open a beer on Spaces last night? I swear he was.
You mean earlier this afternoon?
My bad. Yeah. Jesus Christ.
Dude. Mate, you lose track of time. The hardest thing in my life today has been trying to manage the DMs. You know, the DMs. Every single person in the DMs has had like a jaw picture, and I've been getting like 25 DMs an hour or something, dude. And it's like horrific trying to deal with all these jaw pictures. Like, this cannot go on. Like, I'm so happy, like, the jaw situation, the picture lasted, but dude, it has to come to an end. I'm just trying to get your man raccoon in. I'll put the laptop on, shall I, Gaines? We've had the rap. Hey, Gaines, can we get an opinion on the rap? Who thinks what? And they might have some feedback. What about band? Band, you got any feedback on the rap? Rap.
So wait, somebody sent that to you, or you had that made, or I don't really know. I was listening to the song. Obviously, it's about NFTs and Robo, but somebody made the song for you?
Did you have it? Shout the hood, darling. Shout the hood. This morning, the hood shipped. We respect the hood like gangster town. We got that slipped under the doormat this morning. Oh, it's lethal bands, isn't it? Nah, 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 nah. Jaffer, your man's first time singing.
Who was singing that?
Nixon, who was starting? Nixon, who did the first rap? You must know the first rap band. Welcome
no,
to
when you said Nixon. I honestly, I'm thinking Richard Nixon. I'm thinking maybe there's like a Richard Nixon SD rack out there that you're like one of one Richard Nixon. You know, I don't know, but I now I know.
yeah, man, Richard. Yeah, if you've got YouTube though, if you've got YouTube, just Google "Welcome to Rackville." RACVILLE. Actually, the YouTube algorithm is quite good at like capturing that the first time you write it. Obviously, there's no "Welcome to Rackville" anywhere else on there. Gaines, can we play that one or not? I can play that one. I'll put it on the speaker. Wait a minute.
It's hard to compare without hearing them at the same time, huh? Go ahead, bro. Go ahead. I was going to say, this is still catchier.
Is that Homestead? Is that Homestead? Hello, Homestead.
Yes, sir.
Hello, sir.
Good morning, sir. Getting some lunches packed.
Wait a minute. You're not auditioning for fucking Seffy and Bruce. Drop the sir, please.
Listen, sir. Sometimes sir is needed. It's just him being polite. But sir, how can I?
Well, not with me. Not with me. I'm a pleb. I'm a pleb. He doesn't need to be polite with me.
Like people,
I'm a pleb.
Here's the thing, though.
I'm a pleb.
People, listen, where you're from, right? People want to respect.
Noted. So,
I've been called ma'am before.
Noted.
I don't feel too bad about it. I don't know.
I'm going to have to leave the space because I can't hear him.
Can't hear who? Home pleb. You can't hear home pleb or?
No, I can't.
Oh, he's dropped. Oh, no, he's coming back. He's going to come back, mate. Hold up. Will I get there? Welcome to Rackville. Let me sort that out on the Bluetooth speaker. 2 minutes.
Gotcha.
Vance, so what's new since 2 hours ago?
Vance,
sorry.
Vance, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you perfectly.
Okay. 1 sec. Let me bring up Homestead. When you go to sleep, when you have dreams, do you remember your dreams like when you wake up, or do you remember them like hours later, or do you not dream at all?
I do dream, and if I dream, I remember it immediately after I wake up. And sometimes, like, I wake up and then like I'll fall back to sleep and I'll re-enter the dream. Is that, you know, the same exact thought or whatever restarts again? Does anybody else have that?
Interesting. I don't know. I have a hard time remembering my dreams. The only time when I can really remember them, like, is when I've been sipping on a little bit of alcohol. Or if I'm like plastered and then wake up.
So
I'm like, damn, that was a crazy dream.
I was watching this or listening to this thing where they were talking about lucid dreaming and how people train themselves to be able to dream lucidly, like be in their dream and like be aware that they're in a dream, but still stay in there. And there was like a bunch of tips and stuff. I never did anything, but I thought it was very interesting.
Seffy's a doctor, right?
Yeah, but I think he's off duty right now.
Oh, okay.
I used to get sleep paralysis sometimes. It's pretty wild. I don't know if anyone else has ever had that.
Yeah, like you feel like your eyes are awake, but you can't like open your mouth and move. Is that what you mean?
Yeah, it's like someone's like kneeling on your chest.
Yeah. I think you're still asleep.
Have you heard about that shit when people go for operations? I've heard people go for operations, right? And the anesthetic doesn't like put them like to sleep properly. But like the people think they're like asleep properly. It's a very rare thing, isn't it? I was hearing about this before and I was like a bit freaked out. Wait, guys. Tell me if this is sound is bad, no? Wait. James, that bad or not?
It's like...
It's the rec show coming from the rec store.
It's good, it's all right.
It's all right. In the back floor. Let's go, chillin' with your coons by the back door. Take calls so you can stay
more. All I wanna do
is make it all right. But upon this crew and
doing all right,
we wreck real bitch. ready to fight. So many raccoons ready for the boss fight. I might fly high like a kite, right? But always ready for a shine for the right prize. Raccoon supply has the right prize. Giving you respect if it's
likewise.
So I'm buying all the
mean guys with the clean hearts.
Read between lines, laser beam to lean eyes. Warrior with clean lights, trash mouth, mean smile, be wise, NFT wise.
Like a cheese guys. From the stash hat. 100 NFTs in my backpack.
Crazy rat
from the stash app.
Rat will take a lead in this haystack. It's the rat trap from the backlash. 100 NFTs in my backpack.
What's this? Thumbs down?
Joe Mama got the thumbs down.
Rat will take a lead in this haystack. Blast that rat crap from the stash app. Supplying the raccoons with a hat bang rap. Rat gang hit the rat will slang like a trash can.
Where?
Bang
where?
And a gold chain. It's either rat bill
or the rat bill.
Best chill while we getting
best
the
first kill.
Best bill, best boss with the best skill. No shill, all real. Secret is a
great deal.
Rat will insane.
I Shane love the fact best that you get words
here. With straight facts. Where? The dog? Where?
The best plan yet.
Winston gonna eat if you retweet. Me fucking dog, man.
Me
dog.
Can I always ready
if you're there, that's.
Buying all raccoons for his trash stash. Trash panda biker gang.
Motherfucking hashtag. Woo! 100 NFTs in my backpack.
Crazy rat flap
from the stash app.
Rat will take a lead
in this haystack.
It's the rat flap from the back lap.
100 NFTs in my backpack.
Crazy rat flap from the stash app. Rat will take a lead in this haystack.
So I'm just going to say, right, that always, and I mean fucking always, right, politics is downstream of culture. And what I've witnessed in the last almost 2 years of being a fucking hardcore IBC degenerate cunt, right, like what I've witnessed and the politics and what you're seeing now, the unfolding of it all, right? I personally, like, all right, if you want to work in full time in crypto and you want to have an opinion, great. I haven't got time for that shit. Like, all the fucking, how long have they been talking about this? The Atom 2.0 shit and then the fucking vote. I blocked this cunt and I muted this shit a long time ago. I feel sorry for the people who have got skin in the game, right? But always remember, culture, right? Politics is downstream of culture. Culture is upstream of politics, right? What Raccoon have done is not get involved in the little bitching, right? Our pull requests were ignored for nearly like 40 days. What did? Did we cry? Now it's built in the meantime. We got ready, we prepared. And I'll tell you what, there's a reason why someone like Jake, right, will come in at our spaces, yeah, which he has done a few times now recently. And he's like, man, you fucking dudes, man, you're killing it. Keep doing what you're doing. Keep building, keep shipping, keep ignoring the noise. Because sometimes that's what it comes down to. Like, if you want to be mainstream and, like, be involved in what's happening right now, like, yeah, we've been having spaces and scandals and talking about it. But I mean, like what you actually care about and what you're invested in. Man, I went fucking solo on raccoons like 4 or 5 months ago. It's been the best journey in history. It's been the best moment in my life. Like, what else have I got to say? We build culture. They come. And the people that come help us to build more culture. And more are going to come. And we're going to get lunacy, lunk, or whatever they call it. And we're going to get on Luna and we're going to rape every fucking Cosmosm fucking chain for fucking liquidity before we fuck off to Celestia. Anyway, Gaines, hello. Am I talking shit again? Shall we get on with a drop or what? Robbo's on a one.
Holy. Did you just shit on Luna there a little bit?
Listen.
I'll shit on everybody, man.
Okay, listen, let me tell you something. I sometimes sit in around a panel. It's like 5 or 6 people in it, and they really, really love Luna. Like, really badly. And I'm like the only person in the group that's like, maybe we need to be a little bit careful, but they're like 100% gung-ho. And these are brains. These are guys with like big brains and stuff like that. So I'm not
give me the liquidity
Luna thing. I'm not
give me the liquidity thing.
What do you mean give you the liquidity?
Let's rock him. Let's suck it all out. The right Asians over there.
But I'm trying to like figure out, like I listen to them and it really is an adoration of Luna, an adoration, a love so hardcore for Do Kwon and what a visionary he is. Like I literally felt like I was in a church listening to people talk about Jesus. But
right, wait a minute.
I'm 100% sure, you know?
Lance, fill me in, because I'm way behind the times. Guys, I'm going to admit, I don't even know what the price of like Luna is or Lunacy right now. I mean, no, Lunacy is in the dustbin. But wait a minute. What is the prominent coin or chain or what the fuck is happening over there? Because I've got no idea, except we can plug into Lunacy if they enable IBC, and we can just drain the fucking plebs, the Dijon pleb liquidity, like just to pay our devs for a couple of months. That's all I'm looking for. How can we pay our devs for the next fucking 3 months? That's all I care about. What's going on, Bans? Can you give me a summary over there?
Of what's going on with Luna? No, because I only have to listen to it when I go to that meeting. The only
thing. Wait a minute. Which chain? Okay. Which chain is Do involved in? Is he in Lunacy or is he in Luna or is he in both? What's happening with Do the pleb?
I mean, he came out of the woodworks as soon as what's his name? Sam Bankman-Fried was like out and he messed up. So he probably felt all comfortable and was like, well, I'm here and I'm here to stay. I'm not the only one that, you know, kind of fucked up. But at the same time, I don't know. These people are definitely worshiping I'm not into it.
All the rats came out, didn't they? Suzu came out and Kyle came out. Kyle Davies, aye. The fucking rat bastards. Anyway, I'll reserve that conversation for another time, obviously. That is interesting, though. The door would come out. So he's been quiet for a while, has he? I thought he'd been outspoken. I don't know. I've tried to stay away
He came out on that coinage interview, and he was there for like a good hour. He went into the coinage interview. Then he went into like a small group of only like, I don't know, 20 people and was talking in there. This is about the same day and when everything with the FTX happened. So he was on. He was quite vocal that day.
He would be, wouldn't he? Anything in crypto that's going to throw the heat off him onto someone else. What an absolute pleb. What a pleb.
So, I mean, there's enough people that believe in him that, you know, I don't know. They're just like, see, you know, they're trying to say that it wasn't Do, that everybody else did that to Do Kwon, and that's why this happened. Not, you know, not because of anything else.
Look at the entire industry, though. Like, what a bunch of fucking cunts, man, left, right, and center. Like, whether it's Andre Cronje and Sifu and Tetroid fucking rubbing the fucking ecos, whether it's Do over there, whether it's the fucking Cosmos Wash Traders, man, whether it's Pedo Gav over fucking Polkadot. Like, honestly, I can't believe that I'm at the stage in my life where if it wasn't for raccoons, right, I'd be out of crypto 100%, right? But I see what we're doing and I believe in it, right? But someone like me who was like, all right, okay, crypto has the possibility to change your life, Robbo, you know, forever in positive ways, right? And loving and embracing every minute. How can you tarnish someone like me that came into it with a pure heart, full of like emboldened with like the prospect of like a future utopia, you know, guys, where we can like trade amongst ourselves and we don't have to go through fucking several entities, blah, 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 right? You know, the drill, yeah. No corruption due to the fact we have an immutable ledger, blah, blah, blah. How can fucking, this is what annoys me every day, man. Every day I wake up with this, like, how did these people, these plebs, these cunts, right, like turn me against something that I thought was going to empower the entire human, or as a fin, right, Finn's here.
First of all, you are so fucking loud. It's 5 a.m. here. My neighbors can fucking hear you, bro. Second of all, don't talk about dough like that. You know, I heard you. Don't talk about dough like that. Okay. Unless the Cosmos and Juno and all these other little fucking foofy chains want to start archiving their own fucking spaces. Yeah. I'd watch your mouth.
Thank you, Finn. I'm just saying that I'm not sure how I feel about dough. I don't think I'm let's just chill out, Finn. I'm getting nervous, Finn.
Nobody has to feel any sort of way, baby. Nobody's got to feel any sort of way. I'm just saying, when loud ass fucking plebs start yelling about shit they don't know about, calling people cunts without them actually being cunts, that man is one of the nicest people. Hey, you shush, you shush, you loud fuck, shush. That man is one of the nicest fucking people, one of the realest fucking people I've met in this space, besides Joe.
That's what Joe said about Charles Hopkins.
I bet that dude's nice too. There's a couple true altruists in this space. And then there's a whole bunch of fucking liquidity chasing fucking rats. All right.
Wait, you think Charles Hopkins is altruistic?
I think he's one of the nicer in the spectrum of what we deal with here, as far as like psychopathy versus altruism and everything. I do believe that Charles is on the nicer side of the spectrum. He's trying to do things properly.
Too bad.
But I've never, met the guy.
Hold on. Can I say something real quick? It's really hard to, after reading about all the different things and all those strange things that Charles Hopkins did while he was part of the Ethereum group. And yeah, this was like, 2014, or, this was then. He got fired and let go. Like, it's hard for me to trust and to feel good about somebody who makes up stories and who's constantly caught in lies and stuff like that. That to me is weird. Like, okay, maybe he's just a really nice guy, but he's just a liar. Like, I just don't understand the correlation, and I can't say he's a nice guy if he's going to sit here and make up stories and make people feel so uncomfortable that they literally locked the door. When he got fired, they locked the door and they all slept in the same room.
And see, that's interesting. I never heard that. And that's probably true. But also remember what they did with Snowden, what they did with that other dude. Like, you can't really trust what you read all the time. Granted, there is probably some truth to it. I don't really know that much about him. I'm reading the experience I've had.
I'm reading Laura Shin's Kryptonians book, where she has over, 3 or 4 years of interviews and notes and stuff like that, and where she wrote this book, and she had gathered this information from the people that were actually involved in the situation with Charles Hodgkin. So she also
had Fat Man Tara on and didn't really do a very good job interviewing him. So I mean,
how can you interview Fat Man Tara? He freaking sucks his teeth and he talks in weird voices.
Hearsay. This is all hearsay. Can we agree? Two bear markets, and we don't have any fucking Cardano or smart contracts. I mean, in the history of the fucking world, this must be a first.
Yeah, I'm not supporting it, dude. I'm just saying, like, there's a difference between maliciousness and just taking your time or whatever the fuck he's doing. You know, intent, man. It's all about intent.
Your man. Dude, we were at the peak of the fucking bulla. And your man's out in the desert riding on fucking stallions with eagles on his arm and a fucking McDonald's in the other fucking hand. And I'm like, who the fuck is this in charge of billions of dollars? What is going on? Robo, sell everything now. Depart this market. Like, immediately, what the fuck?
The signal was that song by Zucker Nerd's fucking sister. That was it. That was the top. We all should have sold.
Where's Brusk?
Fortune favors the brave.
Is that right, though? Have we been through two bear markets? and your man, Charles, has never shipped.
That shit was one of the first cryptos I ever bought, like back in 2017 or 18. Like, they've been around for a fucking hot minute, not really doing much, but, you know.
It's like a groomer coin. It's a groomer coin, isn't it? It's been a groomed, yeah. Grooms all of us, doesn't it? I came in on the door as well. Adora XRP, the groom me, those two.
You know, the first cryptos that I bought was Bitcoin, XLM, and Ethereum. Those were the first crypto that I bought. I really still like XLM, though. But...
I bet you didn't put in a cold wallet. If you did, you would have been horrified. I remember me getting...
Not XRP, XLM. Stellar XLM, not XRP. XLM.
Yeah, XLM. I mean, they all had decent runs. They all had good ideas. They were all cheaper to send than fucking ETH. But so is Kujira still a thing, or did Jacob crash and burn that shit while I was sleeping?
Oh, you went to bed. Wait. You went to bed. And one of the Kujira people, Gaines is going to pick up after I stop speaking. One of the Kujira Senate dudes came in, and I just let fly about them shatting raccoon. I was like, your man's in here. He's in the spaces. He's in the chat. Well, I'm putting you all on notice. You want to listen, you plebs. And it made I went off it. Sorry, Gaines.
No, you're good, bro. I don't even know what you're talking about.
Between them front-running racks on the casino over there and then what's-his-name going to work for Gelato. Excuse me, Gelato. Yeah, this bear market's taking its toll. You know, it's good to see some of you still here and not suffering from severe mental depression. I definitely appreciate seeing all the Joes in the house this morning. It's always good to wake up to a nice set of Joes.
Kujira's pulling a fast one there, in my opinion. Like, but I mean, they're welcome to come on the show and explain themselves. You're welcome to come and answer and walk the plank, as we often do. But
yeah, you know, from what I gather, you know, Osmosis, maybe they want their books, maybe not. Jacob, you know, I have a lot of respect for the dude. I thought it was funny as fuck how he goes about his business. But when you start going about your business all over my bags, then we have a problem. And Kujira is one of my smaller holdings, one of my only holdings. After liquidating my Juno, my Atom, and all those other Cosmos shit coins. So I think it'll be interesting if you know, their code's audited. I don't have a whole lot of money in there because I'm a peasant, but you know, I hope it doesn't all burn. Now I want an apology for what you said about Doe. I want you to issue a public apology for what you said about
me.
Doe. Yeah,
what did he say about
everybody.
Him?
Everybody that ever said anything bad about him, that man is a saint.
Fucking player.
I can't. I don't know him. So all I know is I lost money. And then a lot of people were upset.
Join the club, sister. We all lost money.
That's all I can remember. That's all I know.
And I mean, shit, I lost money on Raccoon, you know? I'm not up here calling Robo a cunt. I mean, I am. But not because of that.
LOL.
Wait a minute.
Brought it up just now.
Everyone is responsible for their own losses.
About it. But
I just want to say, did Lil Gaines change his profile picture, or is this just Twitter fucking with me?
We're on Day of the Joes part two.
No, I changed it. I changed it.
You changed it to a rack. He's no longer a Joe.
No, that whole thing's over.
That's a lethal PFP. Lethal, that's a beauty, that, like, isn't it? But I think tonight you might see something even more amazing. Gaines, can I give a shout out to White Marlin Staking? I don't know what White Marlin Staking is staking anymore. I don't know what chains are they still validating on.
Did you shut your Kuji validator off, White Marlin?
Fuck Kuji, man. Fuck Kuji, man.
Is it all because of the closed source stablecoin? Is that what the whole hoopla is all about? Just the closed source?
Yeah.
They want to see the books, and they're like, "Nah, we're not showing you the books because you're our competition. So suck it slow from the back and fuck off, kid."
Well, you don't have to use a stablecoin if you don't want to. I understand the risks. I understand why Jacob is saying like there could be something in the code, and they could just once you get
there could 20... be there could be, and none of us know enough to look at the code. So we just got to trust the people that do. And you know what? Sometimes we get burned, and sometimes we don't, and that's the gamble because it's tough.
But why
you can't deal with it being a fucking casino, then crypto ain't for you.
Yeah, and that's why it's like. He's already said that it's public knowledge. It's a closed source code on a stable coin. Anyone who touches it, you're playing with fire. So don't touch it. Everyone needs to understand you are responsible for your own losses. Like there's no safeguard.
Right. Bonds and then Homestead. But bonds first, bonds. What were you about to say there? Then it's Homestead, please. Yeah.
So I find it interesting. Isn't HBARS HBARS a different token or whatever? But isn't there software proprietary and private? Like you can't look into it anyway. So when you're doing business with HBAR, their software, their blockchain, all that shit is proprietary information that is only
Something Osmosis wants.
I know, but I'm just saying, like that's not the only one out there doing it. Somebody else's.
It's been open source.
HBAR has?
Right.
Yeah, it has.
Okay.
I mean, the whole thing, too.
It wasn't in the whole court, for a long time.
Oh, okay. So this is just recently that it was open source?
Yeah, I think it was like a couple months ago or something like that.
Oh, okay. So
did they threaten to shut down all their validators until they opened it, or did they just do it naturally, like in nature?
Well, actually, Jacob threatened them, and then they open sourced it.
I was just as gonna ask nature that question.
Jacob's
every,
powerful.
Does every chain have a Jacob Gattican policing the network?
Right. Wait a minute. Guys, I've got three people to go. Wait. Homestead, what have you got to say first before Tang? Homestead?
Yeah, thanks for giving me the mic, Robo. I've just come to accept that Jacob kind of needs a boogeyman each week, or like a teenager, he needs a flavor of the week, you know? Like, I've just come to accept that. And some of these things he kind of takes upon himself or almost like makes up so he can be out there crusading and showing himself as that person. And for good. And again, I think some of it is just Jacob driving his own narrative. Let's just be thankful that
let's keep this objective as much as we can. Before we bring I'm very upset. I'm just saying, let's keep it objective, Homestead. Like I know what you mean, but let's keep it objective to a degree, because there's positive shit we've got to pump out tonight. Homestead, final comments, objective comments. You think people should like wait a minute before the tweet, right? Is that the consensus? Yeah, people should like take 5 minutes before they like just tweet shit. Yeah, right. Okay, Homestead's gone quiet. Tank's gonna come in. Good morning, Tank.
Hey, good morning, guys. I jumped in right on the good part of the conversation. I feel like I just wanted to say, you know, I understand where Jacob's coming from. Kind of like Mayor was saying, but at the same time, like it's a it's definitely a good thing as well. Like it maybe might teach people not to over degen if you don't know the code and you don't trust it, but you still want to participate. Well, guess what, guys? You know, there's pros and cons. So,
yeah, I was actually going to say exactly that. Like it comes down to the user, and I think if Jacob's true intention is to educate people, then there's a different approach that he should be taking. But at this stage, it's like I 100% agree with Homestead that it's just become, you know, this persona that like every week or every 2 weeks there has to be like something that he fights for. And I mean, that's fair because that's actually a marketing and branding tool. So I understand that. But people also need to realize that. And I think that a lot of people kind of just give, like, this is like a type of thing where I could see someone building a lot of credibility. And then at some point, potentially abusing that the same way that he claims everybody else is. I'm not saying he's going to, but that's kind of like the danger here, I guess, is that when you begin to unilaterally trust someone just because they're critical of other projects, you kind of create your own blinders, so to speak.
Hey, I just want one thing real quick before I got dropped down, Robo. I got to drop down there for a second. I just want to add one thing. You know, just because code is closed or open source doesn't mean, like, even if it's open source, does not mean it's safe. Like, it's still, like, it doesn't add any extra, like, level of safety net for you. So, yeah. Anyway, I love the conversation, guys. I got to drop down so my kids can go to school.
Nobody can take care. I do want to address guys, though, very quickly. Because I'm about to do some shit and I'm going to listen to your conversations. I do want to say before Cosmos Joe comes in, the OG Joe, that Rama addressed the cult of personality very quickly and explicitly the other week, and has done actually twice now since then on a Spaces. We've been having many hours, so there's probably like stuff that people in the rooms missed. But Rom has actually like made some very public statements one-on-one with people when everyone else is listening about the cult of personality. So I get where y'all come from. I don't want to halt the conversation. Joe, you got something to chip in, Joe, yeah?
Yeah, I think when it comes to Jacob, he probably means well, but he overshoots the mark almost every single time. And then by the time he backs off, shit is already burnt to the ground. He absolutely demolished Gelato. He went hard after Orbital Apes for no reason. I don't think it was even close to being justified. But obviously, you know, if he sees a red flag, he interprets it as a catastrophe, and he goes right to Twitter publicly when I think it could be handled a different way. But he's building a brand, and now he's known for this. He's part attention whore, part crusader, is what it seems like to me.
Yeah, I think we just need to decentralize Joe.
I mean,
well, attention whores.
The other thing, though, is if you think about it, and I'm not trying to draw, I guess, a comparison between SDF and Jacob, obviously, but this whole idea of effective altruism is kind of like what Jacob's trying to do for Cosmos, is trying to be like, trust me, I know best, like, just listen to me, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, look, man, if you want to put the facts out there so people can be educated and make their own decisions, that's fine. But the second you start putting your own spin on things and you're trying to, like, you know, shove a narrative down people's throats, like, it's just not okay. And the other thing that I saw a lot of after the whole Jackal thing was he literally went in, like, I can't even count how many Discords and posted just these, like, insanely long fucking posts about how Notional is leaving Jackal. And I'm like, bro, this isn't a fucking airport. Like, you do not need to announce your departure, like, for everybody to hear. Like, literally just leave the chain, post on your own Twitter, and just, like, leave it alone. But it just doesn't seem like that's just not enough for him. Like, he needs to basically take down someone with him. And I'm like, why the fuck are you doing that? Like, what's the point of that?
And it's with regularity. Like, he has to keep himself in the news at all times. He's very, you know, he's very good at that, and it's good for his brand. Listen, I have him blocked, but I delegate to Notional, and I don't have Notional blocked because I can't stand his communications.
That is amazing.
That's how you decentralize a chain right there. My man, Joe, at the top of the game. Love it. I need to go get Joe.
That's all right. Got a cup of Joe. Go and get a cup of Joe, Finn. Because, Finn, you need to come back. There's got to be some crack very shortly. Because, we go from the serious to the crack to the serious, right? I like this about the decentralization. I'm wondering if the 1,500 bucks a month or whatever, which is like a pittance that they're going to, like, pay Rama, I wonder if that, like, 1,500 is just, like, police, Jacob. I wonder if, like, the Notional Collective have just, like, come together and said, like, Rama, keep this cunt in check and we'll pay you like 1,500 a month just to fucking have a word with a fucking pleb. Like,
well, didn't Jacob reply to one of the tweets that it said, like, he's the one who keeps me in check and does it the best?
Yeah, he basically did. Actually, I saw that too. That's pretty funny.
Hence my comment. I'm just out, guys. I'm going to go for a walk. But hence my comment. This is quite a funny fucking... Is it me, or do we live in quite a funny environment right now? I don't know, like, this is fucking, it's all getting a bit like, we must be scraping the peak or bottom right now, now. All this shit, like, when we're in the buller, nobody ever cares what anyone says. Peak of the buller, like, your man could say what he wanted, no? We must be, like, near the bottom now, like, guys. Nah? Are we not? Am I reading this market wrong or what?
We're getting close. We're getting close.
Whatever happens with the assets that are being not only held by FTX, but then also whatever people are in insane amounts of debt we don't know about yet. Like, I mean, I'm curious to see what happens by Monday if Genesis isn't able to raise $1 billion. Because I think, like, that's the kind of stuff that, like, aside from the technicals, like, those fundamental things are going to drive what happens next. I actually think
how much did you say Genesis had to raise?
$1 billion.
Sure.
$1 billion.
Wow. So last Saturday, because we were live last Saturday, we were doing the 35-hour spaces. They got a, what was it, 170 or 175 mil injection on Saturday. And that was double their exposure to FTX. Why did Gemini, Genesis OTC, which is Gemini essentially, why did they get double the cash injection that they had exposure to with FTX? I still can't get my head around that. And now they need another 800 million. They need, like, fucking
I think it's like one of two things, right? The first thing is, like, they probably didn't want to come out and say how bad it was initially to spook, like, markets. Or even worse, it could just be, like, poor accounting, poor understanding of where all of their loans are. Like, it's clear at this stage that I think people were just degenning around as much as we were, like, and they don't know where their shit is. And now that they're actually looking at the books and realizing, like, oh fuck, we have money over here, that's illiquid, this isn't working, like, we need to raise funds, like, immediately, like, it takes a while for them to get all that shit together. And that's why I think the next month is just going to be a series of these types of, like, oh, we fucked up, like, we need this amount of money. If we can't get it, like, sorry. And that's why I'm kind of nervous to say, like, this is the bottom. But
I was listening to your woman the other day talking about the synthetics between exchanges and, like, how it works. And they were talking about, like, the paper Bitcoin and that. Like, I mean, I don't know about anyone else. I've researched, like, Mt. Gox. I wasn't around when Mt. Gox, like, kicked in. Like, what you're saying right now, And people are saying, like, Mt. Gox is worse. Well, the real people are like, nah, this is, like, 10 times worse, like, the contagion. I don't know how anyone feels right now. Like, if you've got massive exposure, I do feel, like, sorry for you, right? If you have got massive exposure. If you haven't, sit back and enjoy the ride. Like, grab a mojito in the hammock. Let's all chill together. Let's buy some racks. Let's trade some racks. Let's launch some shit. Let's deploy some fucking more slots. Let's find another L1. Let's do whatever. But, like, I'm determined not to let this shit infect, like, what we've created. Because what we've created, where we can all come together and have some fun, is far more important, man, than fucking losing your shit, man. Anyway, guys, I'm busy. I'm going to shop.
Robo's out shopping on the streets of Bangkok.
The dirty streets of Bangkok.
I love the fact that he goes about his day and just stays on the Twitter space, and, like, it blows my mind that he is the PFP with a guy walking around with a giant tablet talking into it. It's like,
I was gonna say, do you think he's walking in the store with the tablet to his ear still?
Oh yeah,
he hasn't gotten
the true story. It's a true story. The tablet. No, I can't. Darling, I've got a Samsung Galaxy S2. I can't bring myself to use it. I'm walking now down the street with a tablet in my hand, darling. I'm not joking. This is some real shit going on right now, man.
Is there reporting live from Bangkok. And I want to see what this looks like. I need a picture. Just real quick. Just
Lol, hit me. Lol, hit me in the village.
You got the headphones wired in, right? You got wired headphones on, right?
No, I'm on the JBLs. I'm on the JBLs while I'm walking to the shop. Wait, guys, I had two when I left the house. The fucking right ones dropped out. Fuck, how did that happen? Shit. Fuck, I left the house with two. I've got fucking one now. Fucking bastard. Don't worry, TVs are like,
You got one. You got one headphone. So the volume is the same with just one, it seems like.
God damn. Hey,
those JBLs.
I want to pick up where Robo left off, guys. He was about to give White Marlin a shout out. And I just got a DM from him saying that he validates on Osmosis, Stargaze, Chihuahua, and Namek. And apparently Passage too. But he says, like, I don't know if that's like an inactive one right now. Not sure. White Marlin, if I'm wrong, just correct me. Send me a quick DM.
Did you guys see the other proposal on Osmosis that they're gonna lower incentives? I think it's 364. That instead of putting incentives towards LP pools, they're gonna redirect some of the inflation towards the community pool. I guess the community pool needs a little bit of a reloading. I wonder why.
That's hilarious. You gotta be kidding me.
Do what?
I said, that's hilarious. You got to be kidding me. I mean,
it's 364. So, right. I mean, it's like, okay, 362. We got to spend all this money on this grants program, outsourcing the grants program. But then 364, we want to replenish the community pool. So what are we going to do? We're going to lower incentives on the LP pools. I'm not feeling it, but it's passing. It's passing. So I'm starting to get a little frustrated with Osmosis governance. I'm starting to. The question is like, if you read through it, the proposal is like about 25 paragraphs, and you got to read through the whole thing to actually. So I think they're lowering the incentives around 21%, if I read it correctly. Maybe I'm not reading it correctly, but so they're going to take that 21% of inflation and put it back towards the community pool.
Oh, man. I mean, I haven't read the proposal, but this has been like one of my personal concerns about the Cosmos ecosystem for a long time, is that in the beginning, staking rewards are insanely high. People who built these ecosystems, obviously had an edge. And were able to, delegate massive amounts to themselves. They now have pretty much all the voting power they need to pass things unilaterally. I mean, clearly. And the people who say they're here to defend the community, last second vote to approve this insane amount of funding. Once we had a community call where they clearly understood that nobody was in support of that and wanted it refined. Like, what does this say? Like, actions speak so much louder than words. I don't understand.
It's because the Cosmos community the Cosmos ecosystem is socially centralized. Vote for the spirit of Juno, damn it.
Yep.
And I think there's got to be a lot of like mid-level and smaller validators that are, it's got to be really tough for validators, because it's like, do you voice your opinion and speak up and possibly get, blacklisted from the inner circle, or lose delegations, or do you just, vote abstain and just try to ride the candy train as long as you can? Because, I mean, these inflation-based tokens, it's not hard to figure out the tokenomics of this stuff. It's like, yeah, if you get mass adoption and, you get a lot of transactions. I mean, let's just talk Osmosis specifically. They do have revenue. It's one of the few chains that has revenue. They got transaction fees, but it's all, it's all in Osmo.
I'm really interested in the first thing you said, someone who works with a mid-tier validator, because I actually thought it was hilarious when everybody was hating on Cleomedes for doing an airdrop. Because it was literally the only thing that saved us from extinction. And we are currently, like, I know Posthuman says that they want to be decentralized, but I'm sorry, that's also bullshit. If you look at their own tokenomics, they own pretty much like most of the PHMN token. So, like, we can talk about that if people want, but I'm more interested in actually sharing, like, the concept and the idea behind what Tank's trying to do and what Cleomedes is actually trying to do with decentralizing operations. Running the nodes themselves has to be somewhat centralized until you have enough people who are trusted to run nodes in a non-malicious manner. But this whole idea of actually having users, delegators who are interested in governance, having subcommittees for each chain that you validate on, with those users driving the discussion, proposals, all these types of things, like that's how we actually deal with this. It's just hard because a lot of people don't want to do all of that stuff. But again, it's like, this is why like calling out a validator for doing airdrops is kind of bullshit, because some of them are going to be, I don't know, like malicious about it, but it was literally the thing that allowed us to stay alive. And right now, I don't know. I mean, we're like trying to make it work, but it's still hard because of exactly what you said earlier, which is you speak out too loudly against certain people and you just get absolutely fucked. And so you kind of have to toe this stupid line of like, how do we advocate for delegators without fucking our brand?
Yeah. And it takes a while for anyone outside of the ecosystem. There's a learning curve. And unless you're very, very tech savvy and you know how proof of stake works, if you're not into computer science or, you know, into cryptographic, you know, understanding proof of stake, there's a learning curve. But once you get in and you understand, okay, proof of stake, you know, let's say you got 100 validators and blah, 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 you know, you figure out how it works, but then you got to figure out the governance, and each chain has a little bit different governance and blah, 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 blah. And so, yeah, these mid-tier validators, I see where they are. They're stuck between a rock and a hard place. And yeah, it's interesting. I am very concerned. I'll just voice this right now. I'm very concerned where the Cosmos Hub is, Juno and Osmosis. Three of the chains I'm very that, you know, they're the most popular chains, you know, and a couple others, but it's like, the chains are in a very like pivotal moment. Like there's some couple different directions these chains can go, and it'll be interesting to see which way they go, especially Juno.
I think you focus more on the chain. Rather than, and I'm on my way home, by the way, I've done the shopping. I think you're more concerned with the chains, whether that be that, the consumer chains, whatever, rather than the validator sets. I think this is where, because I've been listening to like Todd now, probably like listening to what he's been saying for about 2 weeks, 2.5 weeks now since he came on the spaces, yeah? And it's not a rosy outlook for validators right now. And I'm sure like Gaines will attest to that, right? He's had his own problems, blah, 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 with the organization that they have, right? Like, people are looking at the chains right now with concern. Please don't. Like, chains can be spun up tomorrow very easily. It's not that difficult. The validator sets are what need protecting right now. And it's, I mean, if you listen to Todd, Gaines, what was he saying? He's got 11 validators. He's got 11 nodes, right? 11 different chains he's validating on, sorry. And he's only in profit on what, 3? Did he say, or 2?
Really bad. Like, some of them are barely breaking even, I think.
And let me also say that some of the reason why some validators launch on chains like Rebus, which I'm sure you guys aren't a fan of, is because it's fucking profitable and it's funding our other operations. Right now, I think Cleomedes is making close to almost $3,000 to $4,000 a month on Rebus, and it's keeping us afloat on all the other more important chains that we validate on. So again, like, these types of things are things that I think people, delegators, don't realize, and they're like, oh, why are you guys validating this chain? It's like, well, maybe that's the thing that's actually keeping our operations alive.
Yeah, just to go back to what I was saying, I use the word chain, but I guess I feel like, I don't know another word I could use. I guess the protocol, like I feel like the validators are the chain, or, you know, I don't know how to, but I hear what you're saying, Robo, like a chain can be split and forked and, you know, you can start up
validators can start up a new chain. But I guess specifically for the ecosystem, I think, obviously Osmosis has such first mover advantage and the liquidity. But I just think just seeing some of the governance stuff that's gone down and just some of the pushback against the community when they speak up and raise their voice, I don't know, you know, it's frustrating, you know, it's just frustrating.
Well, I'd like to ask you guys, and Mayor, I can't wait for our discussion later on today with our friend Aztec, but I'd like to ask all of you guys that especially have been recently speaking, you know, I put out a tweet and got pretty good acceptance, actually. You know, obviously I know Ram was up for it. Kevin said from ONI that he would be up for it, but I would like to get together a round table of sorts with community members, devs, and validators to actively and record like on a live stream where it's official, like have these conversations out in the open. Would you guys be willing to actually sit down and talk to the entire community? And I'm talking about cross table from devs to validators, community members or whatnot.
I would, because I would quite happily share what I believe is my vision. And I've been maintaining this for nearly 6 months now, that IBC in its current format is not sustainable. We can't keep like capturing validator sets, guys, like we are. If we wanted to, what did Juno go from on the vote? 125 to 150, just after the chain halt, right? What if we want Juno to go to 250 overnight? Is that resource or capability or capacity there? I fucking very much doubt it. We're like, I don't know, because companies like Notional are going by the day. My point is, I think that eventually, dude, very, 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 very quickly, if we keep having all these validator sets launching, like people are not going to be at the keep up, dude. We're gonna the great IBC is gonna outlive or outgrow its validator sets very quickly, like. Is it not getting to that stage right now where you've got like so many people validating on so many chains and they're making fuck all money, man? Something's got to give, dude, no?
I guess, are you trying to say that the sets get expanded, but then the voting power concentrates at the top? Is that what you're trying to say?
It's not the voting power I care about. It's actually like for how people think IBC is going to grow, like how many... like validator sets have we got, or how many validators can comfortably like validate like 11, 12, 13, 14 networks? Like, is this just going to go on and on and on? Because somebody's got to give somewhere along the line. Is it the, are the chains progressing quicker than the validators? That's the question, actually, I suppose.
I'm actually not as concerned about that. Like it's actually fairly easy from a node operator standpoint for a single operator to manage anywhere between, I don't know, 15 to 20 chains if you have all the right alerting mechanisms set up. And I mean, as soon as like it gets harder to scale, you just add more node operators or sysadmins to your team. So like, I don't think that's the concern. I think the bigger concern is like an education problem. Like a lot of people think that if you keep expanding the set, that it's better for decentralization. But all it really does is it fractures like the mid to lower tier voting power. And then continues to keep like the top 10, you know, fairly concentrated. And that's more of the issue in my eyes, is like, how do we actually change the way that the delegation workflow is done so that we don't continue to have this issue?
Yeah, I think there's a lot of different factors involved when you start talking about size of the active set. I've heard a couple discussions about like it, as far as Nakamoto coefficient and all that stuff, and you know how fast you can get to consensus. There's a lot of technical parameters that come into play. But
you want me to make it easy for you, for everyone?
Yeah.
Like Nakamoto coefficient, expanding the active set is nothing. Absolutely zero. Nothing. The only thing expanding the active set does is it reduces the barrier to entry into the chain. That's all it does. It allows new validators to enter the game. The only thing that's going to change the Nakamoto coefficient, proven, is capping voting power. That is the only thing that actually changes the Nakamoto coefficient. SiftChain did it. SiftChain is a total piece of shit chain. I'm not advocating for SipChain, but they actually implemented that and it worked really well. It immediately took the coefficient from 3 to like 7. So that's the only thing that'll actually do that.
You know who has the highest Nakamoto coefficient? Solana. Would you say that's the most decentralized chain?
Yeah, and I think actually Avalanche has a pretty insane coefficient as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then so, I think we can agree that, you know, it doesn't mean anything.
Yeah, and then to that point, right, like we're talking about consensus mechanisms, like that's also bullshit. Like expanding the set doesn't significantly increase block times to the point where it shouldn't be tenable. Like if you're running a chain like Injective that has like these ridiculous like less than 2 second block times, and you're trying to be like, hey, we're the fastest chain in the cosmos, like, okay, fair enough, maybe it might be significant. But for any other like reasonable chain like Juno, for example, that has like longer block times, like that's it doesn't really change much.
Yeah, and so I guess my issue comes back around to governance and the voting power pooling at the top. So and that's a question that's like it's the same in the real world. People with power very rarely will willingly let go of the power once it's attained. You know, and I'm not saying that a lot of these people are bad actors. I'm just saying that people work within their own self-interest, and it's very hard sometimes to be like, yeah, we know we're the big dog, and but we're going to pass this proposition that's going to take voting power away from us. That's very hard to do, but it is doable. I think it's been talked about. I know it's been addressed. But back to your question, Robo, I'd love to try to sit down with. Or I'd love to have a space as just an open discussion. And I know if to get some of the big validators to come in, I'm sure we could probably get Joe Abbey or some of the really open guys to just sit down and say, look, this is an open discussion. We just want to learn more and understand more about the dynamics. This isn't a personal attack on anyone validator.
We've got some devs in tonight. So it's a perfect time to like ask a question, right? Like, okay. So are these IBC app chains, are they monolithic? Are they horizontal? I.e., like, is each of these app chains that we're seeing popping up left, right, and center, right? Are they responsible for, like, the main three aspects of a monolithic blockchain in regards to data storage and sampling, block production, and smart contract execution, right? Like, in the IBC at the minute, and somebody please like jump in and correct me, right? In the IBC at the minute, is there each app chain, and I know you've got like the archive nodes and shit going on and blah, 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 but Gaines might be there. Like, Gaines, is each app chain responsible for those like three main aspects at the moment?
Oh my gosh. Right? I heard my name, guys. I'm super sorry, but I'm kind of like tied up right now. I'm trying to reply to the thread right here on the Spirit of Juno proposal. I'm sorry. What was the question, bro?
That's all right. No, dude. Well, I believe at the minute, I'm sure, I might be wrong, that all of the app chains that we're seeing deployed, they're all responsible. I mean, obviously, they're responsible for their individual like marketing and things, right? But when it comes to like blockchain mechanics, right, they're responsible for their data storage, block production, and smart contract execution, right? All of these individual app chains are all responsible for those three main elements. Is that right? Or am I wrong?
I would say so, yeah, for the most part.
But what do you mean by smart contract execution?
Well, they are not modular, are they? IBC is not modular, is it? Each chain is essentially like its own entity. Yeah, there's interoperability, but there's not like, what is it? Composable. I can't even say the fucking word. Composability. Wait a minute. Rekgang might be correcting me because he might know. Hello, son.
Thanks for checking out another episode of The Ether. That was part one of a two-part Rack FM with the Cosmos Spaces, with the Racks, with the official launch party of the Honorary Council. Recorded on Friday, November 18th, 2022. For TerraSpaces.org, I'm Finn. Thanks for listening. And if you want to keep listening, head on over to TerraSpaces.org/donate and show some support. Now with Spark IBC enabled.
cool. When we blow through the dust, volcanoes erupt. No one ever guessed that the game would be tough. Keep it hands off when the play is a bust. Plain old and just, so we keep it on the one. Blast off on the two, help me see the three. Third eye open wide, checking out the scene. Laser beam focus, star scream jokers. Living off the fat of the people they approach. Tell me what happens when the land fights back. With the cliffs at our backs, make the last stand matter. No one ever planned for the famine on deck. We was walking all erect with a dead man's swagger. Sitting in a little den, envisioning the middlemen. Listen to the fiddle man, play a little ditty then. Talk about how all the leaders seem reptilian. Lost in the maze, trying to make the next billion. Talk about how all the leaders seem reptilian. Lost in the maze, trying to make the next billion. In a little den, envisioning the middlemen. Listen to the fiddle man, play a little ditty then. Talk about how all the leaders seem reptilian. Lost in the maze, trying to make the next no one gave a shit till the drugs all dried up. Everybody died from a bad batch of Lysol. But it didn't matter, we was all hyped up. When the pedal lit the metal, he just didn't have the right skill. Watched in the daytime till the night curfew. Rats in a cage till they make time to murk you. Got a little job that falls under my purview. We gotta get this mob away from the bird's view. Gotta find cover, wipe off the bird poop. Right off the work while you try on the worst juice. Blinded by perps who try to reverse truth. Slide like Fox News just trying to lie to you. Eating up the slop like a bunch of hungry vagrants. I can't wait for the day they lock us up in stasis. Mock up a basement, could call me resilient. Waiting for the internet to make me a billion. In a little den, envisioning the middlemen. Listen to the fiddle man, play a little ditty then. Talk about how all the leaders seem reptilian. Lost in the maze, trying to make the next billion. Talk about how all the leaders seem reptilian. Lost in the maze, trying to make the next billion.
Terra Spaces.